अल्लाह जी
थैंक यू मैम आई थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक ऑन दिस पीस ऑफ लेजिस्लेशन व्हिच हैज कम बिफोर दिस हाउस इन द बैकड्रॉप ऑफ द पंजाब एंड महाराष्ट्र कोऑपरेटिव बैंक स्कैम मैडम द बिल एम्स एज पर द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड रीजंस टू इम्प्रूव कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स मैनेजमेंट एंड रेगुलेशन Infuse professionalism, better governance, and sound banking practices so as to protect the interests of the depositors. So I welcome this bill. Madam, since my time at my disposal is very limited and I have no luxury to go into the cooperative movement, how cooperative banks came into existence, kinds of cooperative banks, their functioning, etc., I'll make just a few quick points for consideration of the Honorable Finance Minister. Madam, I and the Telugu Desam Party are with the Finance Minister as she has aptly demarcated in the bill that banking regulations and guidelines of the RBI are to be strictly followed by the cooperative banks and gives Registrar of Cooperative Societies to deal with administrative issues. Madam, the cooperative banking system in our country was set up on the cooperative basis and belongs to their members. But Madam, if you closely observe the PMC scam, there is a collusion between the bank officials and HDIL. Almost 77% of the loans given to HDIL holding companies, which became NPA and PMC, has gone bankrupt. Here, the point I wish to highlight is, according to the RBI norms of exposure, the bank's exposure to a group of connected companies is capped at 25% and 15% for individual companies. But this was violated, and I did not find any such cap in this bill also, Madam. So I would like to know from the Honorable Minister, how is she going to implement this norm in cooperative banks, and who will monitor this may kindly be explained. Madam, in 2017, when Shri Arun Jaitley was Minister, this very House had given its approval for inserting two sections, 35AA and 35AB, to the Parent Act. The main objective was to strengthen the hands of the RBI to address stressed assets in the banking system. I am sure these two sections are also applicable to cooperative banks, but they are going to be prospective or retrospective is not very clear. I suggest making them applicable retrospectively to cover the PMC scam, which I think is the largest scam in the cooperative banking sector. Secondly, I wish to know the results of implementation of Section 35AA and 35AB in the last 3 years. The cooperative banks are still at the beginning of the cooperative movement. They are not following the modern practices of banking, such as net banking, mobile banking, online banking, e-banking, ATM banking, and other electronic banking ways, and lagging behind in adopting advanced and new technology in the banking sector. So, the Honorable Minister may kindly explain how is she going to address this. I suggest for the consideration of the Honorable Minister to provide a special grant for modernizing the cooperative banks in the country. With these observations, I support the bill. Thank you, Madam.
Subscribe us and press the bell icon for more interesting updates.